Hello friends, this is Rajiv Sharma. The subject of today's video editorial, today's strategic analysis is a unique one. This is on Taiwan, China, WHO triangle. Well, we all know that the coronavirus pandemic, ever since it started off from Wuhan, China, 5 months back. Since then, the world polity is in a tailspin. And I can dare say this, that there are going to be enormous diplomatic and political fallouts for the entire world of this pandemic. Especially China. For China, actually, it is going to pose a far graver threat and a crisis than anything they have known in past so many decades. Ever since, particularly, their resurgence, their rise as a global political and economic might. Now, let us discuss the politics of coronavirus, the diplomacy of coronavirus on the global stage. Taiwan, for example, has stepped up its efforts to milk the pandemic in its favor. And a big event is coming up next week. In Geneva. This is the World Health Assembly to be held in Geneva on 18th and 19th of May. Taiwan is out of WHO. This is strange politics. This is WHO has a lot of questions to answer. WHO has virtually acted. That is allegation. I am not saying this. This is what the Western media says. This is what world leaders say. That WHO has allowed itself to be the handmaiden of China. And at the behest of China, WHO has kept Taiwan out. Mike Pompeo, the Secretary of State of the United States, has appealed to all the nations to support Taiwanese attendance in World Health Assembly Geneva on 19th of May as an observer. Taiwan has urged India also for help. Now, Southeast Asian countries, ASEAN countries, they are under the thumb of China. They have refused to do so. But the door is opening. Taiwan can sense a foot in the door here. Why? Canada has supported Taiwan's case. But New Zealand has supported. In fact, the New Zealand support came yesterday, and today the developments are that China has berated New Zealand and even threatened of bilateral relationships consequences, that the bilateral relationship will be damaged if they were to support Taiwan. Now, before I come to the Taiwan WHO part of the story, let me tell you that it is not as if that Taiwan was never on the WHO attendance list, World Health Assembly list as an attendee. In fact, from 2009 to 2016, Taiwan attended this meet as an observer. China did not object. But then in 2016, from 2016, China has blocked the Taiwanese entry as even as an observer in World Health Assembly. Now, what happened in 2016? In Taiwan, a prominent woman politician, she won the election and she became the president of Taiwan. Now, this is China, the leader's name is Tsai Ing-wen. She's the leader of PPP, DPP of Taiwan. Taiwan, she's looked upon as a separatist by China. Since then, it's a no-go for Taiwan in WHO or in World Health Assembly. Now, the question is, why Taiwan is not being allowed? When, in fact, this is the Taiwan is a single country in the world which has dealt with the coronavirus pandemic in an exemplary fashion. It has had just 440 cases and 7 deaths. This is despite the fact that Taiwan is just about 1,000 kilometers away from Wuhan, where the COVID-19 emanated 5 months back. This is despite the fact that it is so close. And consider the fact that US, which is reeling under the pandemic, which has had over 1.2 million cases and 70,000 plus deaths, it is almost 12,000 kilometers away from Wuhan. A country which is just about 1,000 kilometers away from Wuhan, that is Taiwan, it has done really exemplary way of, it has shown exemplary manner of fighting the pandemic. In fact, Taiwan, WHO spat originated, started in a big way from 31st of December 2019, when Taiwan shot off a mail to WHO asking, flagging the issue of people-to-people transmission of coronavirus emanating from Wuhan, way back in 31st of December, last day of last year, to which Taiwan, the WHO did not respond. At that point, WHO had refused to treat coronavirus as a threat and as some disease which can be transmitted from human to human. But in fact, now there have been reports that several Western powers, intelligence agency has revealed that the Chinese President Xi Jinping had telephoned WHO chief Tedros Ghebreyesus and asked him to defer any announcement for weeks, and in fact 4 to 5 weeks it was deferred. It was only on 21st of January when WHO admitted people-to-people transmission threat from coronavirus. But what Taiwan did, from 2nd of January they started screening all people entering the country, all airports. As a result, they have just 440 cases and 7 deaths, despite the fact that they have maintained close people-to-people contact with China and business contact with China. Now, let me come to the India part of the story. Taiwan has asked for India help. Will India help? Will the Modi government support Taiwan's case? And will it say that yes, Taiwan should be called as observer in World Health Assembly in Geneva on 18th and 19th of May? Well, we don't know. But India has a good case for supporting Taiwan. Because Taiwan donated 1 million face masks to India. 1 million face masks, crucial help. Taiwan can really be crucial in counterbalancing China as far as India is concerned. That is one view, one strategic view. When China has been creating hurdles, has been creating difficulties before India in the diplomatic fora internationally, in the United Nations particularly, over the issue of terrorism, over the issue of many other, Taiwan can be used as a counterbalancing factor for China. But for that, one needs really strong political leadership and strong political will. When Narendra Modi was the prime ministerial candidate in 2014, before he had become the prime minister, he had said he had belittled the UPA2 government and criticized the UPA2 government over its dilly-dallying with China, and had said that you should show red eyes to China. Well, the time has come. Well, we see whether PM Modi now will show red eyes to China, particularly after we have had renewed hand-to-hand combat between the troops of India and China in Sikkim. Last week, as reported yesterday, several, in fact twice, and there was stone pelting between the two sides. This came 3 years after the Doklam crisis, which lasted 73 days. So, well, whether India will support or not, we will see. We'll get to know. So, folks, here I end this video tutorial, and I hope you like this video and comment on it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.